Welcome to the session. This is Shweta Roy, your English Master Teacher at Vedantu. Hope all of you are doing super amazing. And today we are going to start with The Road Not Taken, CBSE Grade 9th in One Shot. So this is going to be the one shot video for The Road Not Taken. Okay, so Road Not Taken is by definitely Robert Frost, who was an American poet. And, you know, he is especially known for his depiction of rural life and colloquial speech, right? So this is a very complex poem, actually. So this is open to multiple layers of interpretations. And in today's session, we will be going deeper into the poem and dealing with all of those interpretations, all of those possible interpretations. You can also come up with your own interpretation if you find that. Okay, and let me know in the comment section. Okay, so guys, I hope you people are enjoying the session so far. And if you want to gain more knowledge, 100% knowledge and score 100% marks, and if you want to join us further, guys, the link is there in the description box and pinned comment. The moment you click on the link, guys, you would be able to join us by getting yourselves enrolled. The coupon code is SWRPRO. The moment you open the link, you will be taken to the page where you can apply the coupon code SWRPRO, and that is going to give you the discount. Theek hai? So guys, now let me talk about the benefits that you're going to get in this platform, and what are the features that we have, you know, only and only for you in this platform. So first of all, guys, you would have unlimited live classes with fun and high level quizzes. Okay, so YouTube sessions are not always live. Okay, we have limited live sessions, but there you are going to avail unlimited live classes. So that is something which is super amazing. Plus, each session will have quiz questions, so the concept that will be taught to you with the help of high level quiz questions, it will be making it will be easier for you, and it will be very, very interactive for you. You will be able to participate in the quiz questions, and you will be able to understand the concept in much, much, much deeper level. So that is something which is very important. Plus, you get exposure because you can compete through the students throughout the world. So that is the kind of exposure that we are giving you guys. Okay, so that again, with the help of debate, discussion, you actually gain a lot of knowledge, deeper understanding of any concept that is going to be taught. Okay, plus if you watch the replay, guys, even that is not at all boring. That is not at all monotonous, because the quiz questions there are live. Okay, so very, very, very interactive. Plus, you have the leaderboard, which is going to appear at the end of the session. So this leaderboard is going to show you your overall class rank and earned points. So that is, again, something very, very important, because you get to know where you stand, since you are competing with students from all over the world. So that is going to almost tell you your rank. Okay, so that is, again, you can work on your strengths and weaknesses. Okay, so that's amazing. Plus, in the quiz questions, guys, after every quiz question you attempt, you will get a fastest finger list, which will tell you your time. Okay, the time that you've taken to complete that quiz. So fastest finger. So that means it's almost like KBC, right? So that is going to very, very, very be very helpful for all of you, because, you know, if you go to any competitive exam, you have to, speed up, right? So we are training you since a very young age. Okay, so that is the kind of training that you're going to get, which will be helpful, not just for your present, but for your future. Theek hai? Plus, premium downloadable content at the end of every session. You can download the notes. Okay, so no problem with the notes. They are readily available at the end of each session. So you can pay attention and concentrate on the session without the hassle of, you know, taking notes in between getting distracted. So that is made available easily to you at the end of each session. Plus, you have doubt solving. Okay, so this is something which is again very, very helpful, guys. Because see, in YouTube sessions, we're not always able to, you know, cater to each and every student's doubt. That's not humanly possible, right? But in our platform, guys, we have made this possible because we have a special team of class teachers only and only for this doubt, this, you know, thing that is your doubt solving. ठीक है, सो दे वुड बी केटरिंग टू ईच एंड एवरी डाउट ऑफ योर्स एंड ऑल योर डाउट्स वुड बी सॉल्व्ड लाइव इंस्टेंटुअसली इन द क्लास. प्लस आफ्टर ईच सेशन यू विल गेट असाइनमेंट सॉल्विंग विच वुड बी एनेबलिंग यू टू अंडरस्टैंड वेदर यू हैव यू नो बीन एबल टू ग्रास्प द कंटेंट दैट हैज बीन टॉट टू यू. प्लस वी कंडक्ट क्वालिटी टेस्ट्स विच इज गोइंग टू अगेन बी हेल्पफुल टू यू in understanding your strengths and weakness and working upon those. ठीक है, and because we are going to give you the performance report which will again help you. ठीक है, next we have free 5000 plus micro courses and crash courses. So if you have any problem with the chapter, guys, with any chapter, you can attend the micro course related to that particular chapter for free. ठीक है, you don't have to pay anything extra. Plus we have started a lot of crash courses right now, so even that is for free, guys, right? So you can avail all of these benefits, guys, just in an affordable price. So what you need to do is just visit the link as I told you and apply the coupon code SWRPRO. And this is for session 2022, the new session. ठीक है, new session के लिए है ये. Pro price is only 2700, but the moment you apply this coupon code SWR Pro, it will be only for 2160. ठीक है, and till March 22, that is 1 year, पूरा एक साल का, guys, only 25919. ठीक है, 25,919 only, guys, for the entire year. Instead of 32,000, if you can save 6% by applying the coupon code, ठीक है, which actually brings down the price to 10.7 per class for the entire year. That is very, very, very affordable, guys. So, ये देखो. That is even lesser than your favorite Maggie noodles, right? So definitely you can check this out, ठीक है? And you just need to click on the link in the description box and use the coupon code SWRPRO. Alright, so resuming back to the session, we would be entering into the line by line explanation of the entire poem. So that, after that, we will be delving into the question and answers, guys, just as it comes in your exam, so that you are absolutely prepared. Okay? So the first stanza, guys, two roads diverged in a yellow wood, and sorry I could not travel both, and be one traveler. Long I stood and looked down one as far as I could to where it bent in the undergrowth. Now you can read through this explanation. Let me explain this very simply. Now see, as I told you, this poem has multiple layers of interpretation. So first we will be cracking the upper layer, that is the literal layer. Kya hai literal layer? Ki ek insan, one person is standing in front of the diverged road. Theek hai? Forked road, ye hai. Crossroad, ठीक है, in a yellow wood. Now wood here means forest, ठीक है. Now why is the forest yellow? Because it is autumn. Autumn में leaves जो है वो yellow हो जाते हैं. That's why it's yellow wood. The traveler is not able to travel both the paths. एक ही path उसको लेना है, right? Now he is trying to decide which path should he take. Sorry. Which path should he take? So he is here in the middle of this path. He had traveler. Now he's standing over here. He is deciding. Okay, he is trying to guess which path would be worth taking, right? So he is looking down as far as he can. यहाँ पे खड़े होके वो measure कर रहा है. He's trying to measure. He is trying to see as the road is, you know, going. He's trying to measure, looking at the road, he's trying to see for a long time, right? Forked road ke beech mein wo khade hoke, stands at the fork in the road for a long time, tries to see where one of the path leads, right? However, the speaker cannot see very far. ठीक है, दैट्स नॉट पॉसिबल, इट्स नॉट पॉसिबल. कुछ लेंथ तक देख सकता है, यहाँ तक देख सकता है, बट आफ्टर दैट ही डजंट नो, राइट? बिकॉज द फॉरेस्ट इज डेंस एंड द रोड इज नॉट स्ट्रेट. सो ही लुक डाउन एज फार एज ही कुड टू वेयर इट बेंट, जहां तक वो मुड़ा, ओके, इन द अंडरग्रोथ, टिल देयर ही कुड सी. दिस इज द लिटरल लेवल. नाउ वी विल कम टू द मेटाफोरिकल लेयर. Now the roads are the symbol of the you know path that we have to take in our life. Okay, now two roads, we have to select any one. Okay, that is definitely a metaphor of our life, the journey of our life. Sometimes we have to select the best out of two. We have to choose one out of two in our life. Right? We can see, when we try to measure the possibilities of path A, let's say path A and path B, we can see, till a short while. We cannot see the entire future, that what is going to happen. We weigh the possibilities just like the traveler is weighing the possibilities of the two roads. We also weigh the possibility, okay, if I take this path, let's say while choosing your career, if I go for this career, A career, what are the possibilities? If I go for that career, B career, what are the possibilities? But can you say, can you look very far? You cannot, see very far, right? So that is not possible. You can look, you can see, you can weigh the possibilities by seeing till a minimum, distance. Uske baad ka, we do not know, right? So that is exactly what he's trying to say, right? Okay, next is then took the other just as fair. So he is actually, the entire poem is talking about the dilemma that we face in our life while trying to choose a path. Okay, so then took the other just as fair and having perhaps the better claim because it was grassy and wanted wear. Wanted wear is an important word. It can come for your vocabulary, okay? We will be doing the vocabulary at the end, so don't worry. Though as for that, the passing there had warned them really about the same. So what is he doing? After trying to weigh the possibilities of both the path, he says that path A, let's say path A, has better claim. Why? That means, he tries to judge. First of all, he tries to judge, right? To be then finally he comes to the decision that okay, one path is good. Why? It's better than the other. Why? It's grassy and it looks less worn than the other path. That means the other path has been traveled by many people. That is why it is not very grassy. And the one path, which the traveler chooses, it's not that grass. It's grassy, and it is wanted wear. That means it's not worn out. It has not been treaded by many people. That means many people did not travel in that path. ठीक है? Though as for that passing there had warned them really about the same. What is the speaker saying? Though now the speaker has actually walked on the second road, after walking on that second road, which he decides has the better claim to be chosen, he or she thinks that in reality, both the paths must have been same. Okay, तो थोड़ा सा चलने के बाद उसको लगता है कि अरे दोनों पाथ तो इक्वल है. Initially, he decides that this path is maybe better, so therefore I should take this path because it is grassy. But after walking a certain distance, he realizes that arey, dono path to same hai. So that is again leading to the dilemma that we also face while decision making, while we have to select between two. Okay, when we select one path, we decide that it is perhaps better than the other path. That is how we decide which path to take. But sometimes it happens after traveling a certain distance in that path, that is the journey of our life, thoda sa aage jaane ke baad, we tend to think, arey, wo le lete to ek hi baat tha. That was also almost same like what I have selected, right? So that is talking about the dilemma that we face in our life. That is the confusion that we have in our life when we need to select our when we need to decide on something. ठीक है? And both that morning equally lay in leaves no step had trodden black. So what did the speaker discover? The speaker recalls that both the roads were covered in leaves which had not been turned black by foot traffic. That means not many people had stepped on that. So in leaves no step had trodden black. If you step on the leaves, if more people would have been stepped on the leaves, it would have been changed into black color, but that was not the case. Then the speaker says, oh, I kept the first for another day. So he says that, okay, let me keep the first which I could not travel for another day. Yet knowing how way leads on to way, but in his unconscious mind, ठीक है, unconsciously he knows, subconscious mind में उसके है, ठीक है, that he won't be able to come back. I doubted if I could ever come back. First of all, he thinks कि ठीक है, दूसरा वाला path, let me keep it for some other day. But in his mind, he already knows that is not possible. It is not possible to explore both the path. We have to select only one. And we would never know what would have happened if we would have chosen the other one. That happens in our life as well when we decide on something. जब हम एक चीज सिलेक्ट कर लेते हैं, when we walk through that, we delve deeper into that path, we sometimes look back and we tend to think, अरे that path. We tend to think about the other path which we have not selected. Remember, the title of the poem is The Road Not Taken. So is the traveler or is the poet trying to ponder upon the road which he did not take? That is again the question that we need to ask. So sometimes in our lives also, we tend to regret ki are wo path dekh lete, what would have happened, but this is not possible. We have to select only one. Coming back and taking the other one which we have left is not always possible, not always feasible, right? This is true in the journey of our life as well. Next is, I shall be telling this with a sigh. The important word over here is sigh. Okay? Right? Somewhere ages and ages hence. That means in the future. He's talking about his future. In future, maybe I would be telling this with a sigh. What would he be telling? Two roads diverged in a wood. Ki do road tha, forked in a wood, and I was the one who took the one which was less traveled by. Here he is celebrating his individuality or individualism. So this poem has been taken as a celebration of individualism because the poet chooses the road which was not frequented by many people. So it would definitely have hurdles. It would definitely have challenges because it is uncharted, it is unexplored, and it is a virgin land. ठीक है? So that is why this would have hurdles, new challenges because people did not travel much, it was not frequented by many people. ठीक है? And that has made all the difference. Okay, so this is definitely a celebration. This is popularly taken as a celebration of individualism because the poet is not going with the herd mentality. Okay, he is traveling in that land which has been, which is uncharted, which is unexplored. He is trying to explore a virgin area, right? So he would definitely have to overcome a lot of hurdles, a lot of challenges in that path, but he is not afraid to explore all of those, right? Now, we do not know what would be the consequences of that decision, right? So, the word sigh is important because it could be having levels of interpretation. Why is he sighing? Is the sigh of relief that, thank God, I had taken the unexplored path, and you know, the path which I felt that many people did not frequent. So thank God, is this a sigh of relief or is this a sigh of repentance that I could not take? The road not taken is the title. So I could not take the other road, okay, and which could have been a different kind of consequences, right? So is the poet repenting on that fact, or is the poet happy because he says that has made all the difference? So is the difference talking about some positive difference, or is it talking about the negative consequence, right? So that is again leaving us with a lot of interpretations and again with a lot of dilemma. So this poem, as I told you, it's a bit complicated. The poet himself has said that this poem is complicated, and the critics, many critics have tried to explore the various nuances of this poem, right? So guys, now we come to the vocabulary part. Diverged. Okay, I would be talking about the very, very important words that you need to understand from here. Diverged is separated. You should know this. Diverged means separated. Yellow woods, a forest with decomposing leaves because it was autumn. Okay? He is highlighting the season of autumn. Undergrowth, you should know. Dense growth of plants and bushes, which means the forest. Okay, then grassy is unused. Wanted wear is important, guys. Had not been used, had not been treaded upon. Okay, sigh is a deep breath, and sigh here has multiple layers of interpretation. It could be a sigh of relief, or it could be a sigh of repentance. Okay, relief or repentance, that we are not very sure. Okay. Hence here means the future. I have already talked about that, right? So I hope you have understood the poem, and now we would be moving ahead with the question and answers, right? Please do let me know the answers as soon as I show you the questions. Oh, first we have to talk about the literary devices. Rhyme scheme is ABAAB. Okay, now the first literary device is simile. Then took the other as just as fair and having perhaps the better claim. So keyword is as, right? So definitely comparison, okay, between the two roads and the keyword, using the keyword as, that is simile. Personification, because it was grassy and wanted wear. So definitely the road is personified, human attributes, human attributes are given to the road. And next is symbolism. Two roads, as I told you, two roads symbolizing the choices that we have to make in our life, right? And next is anaphora, and has been repeated in the beginning of the lines, beginning of 2, 3 and 4, okay? So these are the major literary devices that we have come across in the poem. And now we will be starting with the multiple choice questions. Okay? First, this is the extract. Two roads diverged in a yellow wood, etc., etc. So the very first stanza, guys. The first question from here. What does the narrator mean by a yellow wood? A forest where trees have yellow fruits. The forest where trees have yellowing and falling leaves. A forest where trees have yellow bark, or none of the above. Very, very, very simple. Come on, guys. The answer is yes. Where the trees have yellowing and falling leaves, and I told you it's the season of fall, which is autumn. Okay, moving ahead, what choice did the narrator have to make? Okay, whether to cut down the tree, choose between two trees, choose between two roads, none of the above. Very, very simple. I hope you will be able to answer this. Yes, so between the two roads. Okay. And that is metaphorically representing the choices that we have to make in our lives. Next question is, what does the narrator regret? He regrets the fact that he cannot come back. He cannot travel on both paths. He cannot come back to the start once he makes a choice. The narrator regrets the fact that he didn't choose the other road, or all of the above. Very simple. It would be all of the above, right? So if you're asked this question as a 2-mark question, you have to give all the 3 points, right? So please note this question and note the points, note the options as well, right? And now we will be entering into the short questions for 2 marks. So let's have the very first short question. Does one road seem to be more appealing than the other? Use examples from the poem to support your answer. Okay, so what could you write over here? The narrator or the speaker or the poet. So, write poet, not the narrator. Theek hai, comes to a fork and is not able to decide which path to take. One of the roads look frequent, more frequented by people, while the second appears to be less traveled. Though he is tempted to walk on both, he decides to take the second path with the intention of walking the first one sometimes in future. Alright guys, so yes, so basically the second path was more appealing because it was grassy and was wanted where that is not many people had frequented that road. Theek hai? Therefore, he decides to travel on the second road, although he wanted to explore both. Next, guys, is a 3-mark question. What will the choice, why will the choice between two roads that seem very much alike make such a big difference many years later in the life of the poet? Okay, so a choice between the two roads that seem very much alike is going to make a very difference, a big difference many years later, since this particular decision, this path opened up many opportunities for him. As I told you, way leading on to way. Okay, this means different opportunities. The path which he chooses will open up different opportunities. Okay, so this is talking about our choices that we make in our lives. So let's say we select a path. So that path, going in, delving into that path, going deeper into that path will gradually unfold many other paths, that is many other opportunities, right? So the decision that he now makes will influence him and the rest of the life. And the rest of the decisions also, since the two roads are same, they still have varied options. The two roads look the same, but they will definitely have varied options, multiple opportunities, various opportunities. And the opportunities in road A and road B, although they look alike, they will definitely be different from the other one. Theek hai? Okay. Next, we have the long question, guys. Why does the poet say that he shall tell people this with a sigh? Why do you think the final stanza starts with a sigh? As I told you, the sigh is very, very important. So, the poet comes to a forked road and he decides to walk on the road that was less traveled by. He is not sure if the decision has been the right one, and he feels that if someone asks to justify his choice, he would probably answer it with a sigh. So, as I told you, the dilemma, the uncertainty, because we have to select one road in our life, right? So if people ask you, what about the next road? What if you had selected the other path? Would you be able to say, because you have not traveled that path and it is not possible for us to travel both. So definitely you won't be able to justify the other path that you have not taken. So the road not taken. The sigh could signify two things. As I told you, either it could be a sigh of happiness or contentment at having achieved success in life because of the right choices at the right time, or it could be interpreted to mean that the sigh is one of regret or sorrow at having made the wrong choice. Rather than saying having made the wrong choice, you can say that having not been able to explore the other path. Theek hai? So we do not know whether it is a wrong choice or a right one until and unless we have traveled on both the paths, right? Maybe the next path would have a different set of choices for you, different set of opportunities for you. But it is not possible for us to travel both, right? So that is the case. So it could either mean a sigh of regret or of not being able to explore the other path, or it could be a sigh of contentment, right? So this is very, very, there is an ambiguity in the word, which we find because of the word sigh. ठीक है, so please mention that as well. All right, guys. So now it's time for your homework question. So the road is used as a metaphor for life in this poem. Can you think of another metaphor and explain why that has been used to describe life? Okay. So this is your homework question, guys. You need to attempt this in the comment section. Do let me know. Do let me see wonderful answers from your end, guys. Okay, thank you so much. I hope you enjoyed the session. Don't forget to hit the like button, share the video amongst your friends, and do subscribe to the channel if you haven't. Okay? And yes, don't forget to visit the link in the description box and click.